فؤادك الأيام فتى.
أحاط بكل شيء علما.
So the author now is talking about Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is, he has knowledge of everything. Because the previous point, the Shaykh has just mentioned that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is above his throne. And because Allah is above his throne, it doesn't mean that he is not aware of what's below. Allah is aware of everything and he has knowledge of it. And Allah is never heedless of his creation. Rather, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, بَلْ هُوَ مُطَّلِعٌ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah is one that's looking over them. عَالِمٌ بِهِمْ. He is aware of them. يَطَّلِعُ عَلَى حَرَكَاتِهِمْ. Allah looks and observes their movements and their silences and matters which are very hidden about the affairs of the creation. Allah knows it. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, as he said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he says that we are the ones who created the humans. And we know that which their soul whispered to them. We know it. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he then says, we are more closer to them than the wareed. We are more closer to them. So this being what? The closeness here means by knowledge. Ilman. It doesn't mean Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, because Allah is above his throne. So Allah is close to his creation by knowledge. He knows everything. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah, in the ayah Surah Al-Talaq, وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا, the last ayah Surah Al-Talaq, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah, in that ayah when he was commenting on it, he said, يَقُولُ جَلَّ ثَنَاؤُهُ, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he says, وَلِتَعْلَمُوا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, you need to know, أَنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ, that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, everything, he has encompassed it from his creation knowledge. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. لَا يَعْزُوبُ عَنْهُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. And nothing is hidden from him. There is nothing that he is not aware of. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He knows everything from the affairs of his creation. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. وَلَا أَصْغَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْبَرَ. Nothing little and nothing big is hidden from him. يَقُولُ جَلَّ ثَنَاؤُهُ, Allah says in that verse, and what he means by it is what? فَخَافُ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, be scared of him. Because he knows everything. Be scared of him by opposing his command, because he's going to punish you and he's aware of it. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَمْنَعُهُ مِنْ عُقُوبَتِكُمْ مَانِعُ. And if Allah wants to punish you, there is nothing out there that's able to stop him from punishing you. There isn't. And he is able to do so. وَمُحِيطٌ أَيْضًا. And Allah has also encompassed, subhanahu wa ta'ala, your actions in terms, he knows every action which you do. فَلَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ مَا مِنْهَا خَافٍ وَهُوَ مُحْصِيهَا عَلَيْكُمْ لِيُجَازِيكُمْ بِهَا يَوْمَ تُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he is one that's going to reward you based on the actions and the things that you have put forward. So Allah knows everything. There is nothing hidden from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even that though he, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, is what? He is above his throne. Naam.
لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ.
The author here now, he is talking about Allah's characteristics. The way that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah affirm Allah's characteristics is between what? بين نفي وإثبات. Negation and affirmation. Ahlul Sunnah. They negate from Allah that which he negated from himself and that which his Prophet negated from him. And Ahlul Sunnah affirm for Allah that which he affirmed for himself and that which his Messenger affirmed for him. That is manhaj Ahli Sunnah. And that is their tariqah, their path in which they deal with ayat al-sifat and hadith al-sifat. What do they negate from Allah? That which he negated from himself, which is what? Kayfiyya wal-mumathala. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's characteristics, Allah, we negate from it anyhow. One, number one. We negate from it what? How? Number one. And the second one is what? Al-mumathala. We negate from it that Allah's resemblance of his characteristics towards the creation. We negate that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahlul Sunnah also do what? They affirm. They affirm for Allah characteristics. Which characteristics do they affirm for Allah? That which Allah has affirmed for himself. Ahlul Sunnah affirm it for him. They affirm it for him. Good. And whatever his Prophet has affirmed for him, they also affirm for him. So their affirmation comes to them through what? It comes through to them by the Kitab and the Sunnah. And the negation of theirs comes through to them by what way? By the Kitab and the Sunnah. Not by their logic. They don't say that we negate from Allah whatever our logic doesn't accept. And they don't say that we affirm for Allah everything that our logic accepts. They don't say that. Ahlul Sunnah, their nafi and their ithbat is from the Kitab and the Sunnah. That is very important that a student of knowledge, he learns that qa'idah. Also, what we need to know is that the methodology and the path in which the Qur'an is up on when it comes to Allah's characteristics is that the affirmation, this is a qa'idah you need to memorize, that the affirmation, the ithbat is what? Mufassal. The ithbat is what? Detailed. Allah's the characteristics that we affirm for Allah, we go detailed when we're affirming these characteristics for Allah. The negation, how do we do it? Mujmal. We make it general. We don't go detailed in the negation. So for example, when we negate from Allah, we say, Laysa kamithlihi shay, there is nothing like Allah. We also say, Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. We also say, Rabbu samawati wal ardi wa ma baynahuma fa'abudhu wa astabir li'ibadati hal ta'lamu lahu samiyya. All of those verses, do you know anyone who's equal to Allah? All of those are negation, which are general. Never do you find in the Quran, will you find that the negation is detailed. The nephew is never mufassal in the Quran when it comes to Allah's characteristics. Illa except if there is an ithbat, an affirmation that was before it, in which it is then coming detailed. Such as Ayatul Kursi. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. La ta'khudhuhu sinatu wa la nawm. La ta'khudhuhu sinatu wa la nawm is a nafyun mufassal. It's a negation which is detailed, yes. But before it, what was it? Hay and qayyum. Hay and qayyum, which are if Allah is hay and he's qayyum, la ta'khudhuhu sinatu wa la nawm. So when you want to do a detailed negation, you have to have put before it what? An affirmation which is detailed. Na'am. But to just say, like the Ahlul Bid'ah do, Allah is not above, Allah is not below, Allah is not on the right, Allah is not on the left, Allah is not in, Allah is not out, all of those negations, where did you get it from? You see how? Also, negation, brothers, is not praiseworthy. Aslan. Fi haddi dhatiha, it's not praiseworthy. Negation in and within itself is not what? It's not praiseworthy. Because negation shows Adamul Qudra. And I give you an example. This wall right now, does it oppress? Does this wall oppress right now? The answer is no. Why doesn't this wall oppress right now? The reason is because it doesn't have the ability to oppress. It can't do anything. So is it praiseworthy for him that he can't oppress? No, it's not. Rather, it's ajz, weakness that you're ascribing to him. Does that make sense? وَلِذَلِكَ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ What do they do when they say Allah is not a zalim? They say, وَهُوَ يَقْدِرُ Allah is able to oppress if he wants to. He has the ability. Because stripping dhulm from Allah is not praiseworthy in and within itself. Does that make sense? Because there are those who don't oppress because they can't. They are not able to oppress. Na'am. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to speak about these qawa'id pertaining to al-asma'i wa sifat more inshallah ta'ala in Kitab al-Tahawi when we explain it inshallah ta'ala. So the author, he got here now the ayah, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ It's ayah from the Qur'an, Surah Al-Shura, ayah 11. Surah Al-Shura, ayah 11. That's where he got it from. The first part of the ayah is رَدٌّ عَلَى الْمُشَبِّهَا It's a refutation on who? The mushabbiha. Those who make Allah's characteristics the same as the characteristics of His creation. Allah has refuted them. What did He say to them? لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ There is nothing like Allah. And the next part of the ayah is what? وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ Is a refutation on who? عَلَى الْمُعَطِّلَةِ Those who have what? Who have negated Allah's characteristics, who've chosen not to affirm a characteristics for Allah. That verse is refuting them. Then, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's characteristics, what are the pillars for it? إِثْبَاتٌ وَنَفْيٌ إِثْبَاتٌ وَنَفْيٌ Affirmation and negation. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ There's nothing like Allah. And then Allah affirmed something for him, said, and what did he say? وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ البصير. نعم.
وأنه تبارك وتعالى يرى في الآخرة يراه أهل الجنة بأبصارهم ويسمعون كلامه كيف شاء وكما شاء.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be seen the day of judgment. Aqidatu Ahli Sunnah. And the Shaykh said, وَأَنَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, that he, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, yura, he will be seen fil akhirati, in the day of judgment. He will be seen. يَرَاهُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ, يَرَاهُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ, أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ will see him. How will they see him? بِأَبْصَارِهِمْ, with their eyes. No one has ever seen Allah with their eyes. No one has ever seen Allah with their eyes. Allah has not been seen with eyes. No one has ever. Na'am. But can Allah be seen in this world? Na'am, in a dream. Al-Sunnah believe Allah can be seen in the dream. Na'am. Allah can be seen. But Allah cannot be seen with the absar, the eyesight. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to elaborate on this part, that Allah can be seen in the dream, when we go to Usul al-Sunnah by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Ahmad speaks about it there. And when we explain it there, we'll speak about it in more details. Na'am. So Allah Ta'ala, the author, the reason why he added that part to it, which is what? يَرَاهُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ, the people of Jannah are going to see Allah بِأَبْصَارِهِمْ, with their eyesight. With their eyesight. He's trying to get out of what? That this is something that's not happened before. No one has seen Allah with their eyesight. Good. And also those who believe Allah won't be seen, subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the innovators and those who are corrupted. But Allah has, the Shaykh has said, who are the ones who are going to see Allah? The people of Jannah. The people of Jannah, Ahlul Nar, won't see Allah. Because Allah said in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Ayah 15, كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Ayah 15, Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Allah says about the disbelievers what? That the kuffar, that they are mahjubun. They are veiled from seeing Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. They won't be given that opportunity to see who? To see Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Whereas the believers will be permitted to see Allah, because Allah said in Surah Al-Qiyamah, وجوه يومئذ ناظرة, that day faces will glow. The faces of the righteous people and the Ahlul Jannah will glow. You see? And look, إلى ربها ناظرة, and towards their Lord, they will what? They will be looking towards. And also the ayah in Surah Yunus, ayah 26, Allah says, للذين أحسنوا الحسنى, the people who have done what? And what have they done? The ones who have done good, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He has prepared for them what? Jannah. And also what? Husna. Also husna, ziyada. Allah has prepared for them. Just as a side benefit, which is that there's a fa'idah latifa in here, which is the jar and the majroor. The jar and the majroor are muqaddam, they have been put forward. And where are they sitting? The jar and the majroor, which is lilladina, the lam, which is harful jar, and alladhi, which is ism mawsool, which is ism majroor here, both of them are in the position of a khabar muqaddam. It was meant to be what? A mubtada and then a khabar. Here, what's happened? The khabar has come forward before the mubtada. Okay, before the mubtada. The fi'il is what? Ahsanu. So this is what it's connected to. أحسنوا في أعمالهم, they have done righteousness in terms of their actions, meaning they follow the kitab, they follow the sunnah, they done it with sincerity, they follow the Prophet ﷺ and everything. Where is the mubtada? Al-husna is the mubtada. Al-husna is what? It's a mubtada which is mu'akhar, which is jannah. And then what's the ziyada? The ziyada is a ma'tufun ala, it's connected to what? Al-husna. It's ma'tufun ala al-husna. And this has to be something, other than the husna. It has to be something other than the husna. What is it? The ziyada, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in authentic hadith that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will be seen. When the Prophet recited the ayah, he said, al-ziyada means ru'yatullah, Allah being seen, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they're going to get an additional thing to Jannah that they are already in. They have to get something more, which is what? Seeing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Seeing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And it's like the verse of Allah, لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. Mazid here is what? Ru'yatullahi tabarak wa ta'ala. So, وَلَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا, they have whatever they want in Jannah, that's Jannah. وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ is what? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to unveil from himself, and they're going to see him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the seeing of Allah is an additional reward. It's an additional reward. it is better than the Jannah that they're already in. Because Allah is referring to it as what? Ziyadah. The Ziyadah. Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrated in the Hadith Sahih al-Bukhari that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that Abi Sa'id al-Khudri said anna unasan fi zaman al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that a group of people at the time of the Prophet, they said to him, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, hal nara rabbana yawm al-qiyamah, are we going to see Allah the Day of Judgment? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Na'am, yes you will. Hal tudarrun fi ru'yat al-shamsi bil-zahira? Is there anything, the sun, when it's daytime, it's clear. Is there any clouds? Is there anything between you? Is it so clear? Can you see it? Do you doubt it? Is everything there? They said, Na'am. They said, Dawun laysa fiha sahab. Is there any clouds or anything? They said, No, Ya Rasulullah, it's clear. We can see it. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, alayhi salatu wa sallam, the way that it's that clear and that you can see the day, the sun like that, Satarawakum, you will see your Lord the Day of Judgment, Yawm al-Qiyamati. The way that you see the sun or the full moon, some narrations say, the full moon, the way you see it and it's out there, that's the, and there's no cloud between it, is the same way you're going to see Allah tabarak wa ta'ala the Day of Judgment. Now, some people are ignorant and are unaware of what the Prophet compared here. Did he compare the moon to Allah or did he compare the seeing to the seeing? He compared the seeing of the creation here with the comparing of the seeing of the Day of Judgment. The way that it's clear here, it's going to be clear the Day of Judgment. That not saying that the moon is like Allah, فَتَنَبَّهُ. Be alert and aware of that. Na'am.
وَالْجَنَّةُ حَقْ وَالنَّارُ حَقْ.
Ahlul Sunnah also believe that, as the author mentioned, that وَالْجَنَّةُ حَقٌ وَالنَّارُ حَقٌ. Ahlul Sunnah believe what? From the iman of the things that they believe is that what? That the Jannah and the Nar annahuma mawjudatani, that they are both, they are present right now as we speak. And that they are both created by Allah. La tafnayani, and they will never perish. The Jannah is what? It's a place Allah created subhanahu wa ta'ala for His allies, for His people. And the Nar, Allah created it a punishment for the people of sinners. The sinners and the wrongdoers and the criminals, Allah created it for them. Whoever Allah wills, He doesn't take him to Jannah, even though he's a criminal. Even though he's a criminal, Allah, if He wants, He won't take him to the hellfire. He will take him to what? To Jannah. Adlan minhu, based on His justice, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Imam Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. As Tabaqat al-Hanabil, Abu Ya'la narrated from him, that he said, وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ الْجَنَّةِ, Allah created the Jannah. قَبْلَ الْخَلْقِ, before the creation. Before Allah created the human beings, Allah created what? Jannah, an-nar. Jannah. وَخَلَقَ لَهَا أَهْلًا, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created for it a people. وَنَعِيمُهَا دَائِمٌ, and it's what? It's blessed. And the greatness in Jannah and the blessings of Allah in Jannah are forever to be. وَمَنْ زَعَمَ, anyone who claims, أَنَّهُ يَبِيدُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ شَيْءٌ فَوَ كَافِرٌ, anyone who claims that the blessings that are in Jannah are going to finish and it's going to come to an end, he's a kafir. وَخَلَقَ النَّارَ, Allah also created the fire. قَبْلَ خَلْقِهِ الْخَلْقَ, before Allah created the creations, He also created the hellfire. وَخَلَقَ لَهَا أَهْلًا, Allah also created for a people. وَعَذَابُهَا دَائِمٌ, and its punishment is forever remaining. Its punishment is forever remaining. And Imam al-Tahawi also said in his Aqidah, he said, وَالْجَنَّةُ وَالنَّارُ مَخْلُوقَتَانِ لَا تَفْنَيَانِ أَبَدًا وَلَا تَبِدَانِ. The Jannah and the Nar are both created. They will never perish, and they لَا تَفْنَيَانِ أَبَدًا وَلَا تَبِدَانِ. فَنَأَن تَبِدَان is both the same meaning. It will never come to an end. الإمام البربهاري رحمه الله said the same. وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ مِمَّا أَوْجَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْفَنَاءُ يَفْنَاءُ. Everything Allah has made for it to perish will perish. إِلَّا الْجَنَّةَ وَالنَّارِ, except the Jannah and the Nar. وَالْعَرْشِ, Allah's throne. وَالْكُرْسِي, and the Kurs. وَالصُّورِ, وَالصُّورِ, the trumpet. وَالْقَلَمِ, the pen. وَاللَّوْحُ, the لَوْحُ الْمَحْفُوظِ. لَيْسَ يَفْنَى شَيْءٌ مِنْ هَذَا أَبَدًا, none of those will perish ever. الإمام الأجري said the same. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي كِتَابِهِ, Allah has mentioned in His book, أهل النار, the people of the hellfire, الذين هم أهلها, the people who are the people of hellfire. Allah mentions in the Quran that they are what? يخلدون فيها أبدا, that they will stay in the hellfire forever. وأن أهل النار الذين هم أهلها, and that the people of the hellfire that are made for it, they are in what? في العذاب الشديد أبدا, that they are in severe punishment forever. Allah تبارك وتعالى told us. The same way Imam al-Sabuni said it. Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, in his book Al-Fisal fi al-Milal wal-Ahwa' wal-Nihal, Ibn Hazm, he transmitted an ijma' and an ittifaq that the Al-Jannah and Nar are forever going to remain. He said Al-Jannah wa Nar baqiyatani la tafnayani. He said ittafaqat firaqul ummati kulliha ala annahu la fina'a lil-Jannah wa la li-na'imiha wa la lin-nar wa la li'adhabiha. Ibn Hazm rahimahullah, he said it is agreed by all of the firaq of the ummah, all of the groups, they all agree that what? That the Jannah will not come to an end and its blessings, and the fire will not come to, the hellfire will not come to an end and its punishment. He also brought another ijma' in his maratib al-ijma'. He brought ijma'. Na'am. And this is aqidatu ahli sunnati, that they are all going to remain. Same Hafid Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi, he also said the same in his Aqidah book. Ibn Qudama in his Lum'atul I'tiqad, he said the same. Al-Imam Safarini rahimahullah in his Durratul Mudiyya, Sana'ani, Siddiq Hassan Khan, Mur'i al-Hanabi, Al-Hanbali, Hafid al-Hakimi rahimahullah, all of them, they all spoke about the hellfire coming to never coming to an end. That the hellfire will never come to an end, and that the Jannah will not come to an end. They all spoke about that matter. And مفصلا detail. نعم.
وصراط حق.
The author now is talking about الصراط. What is the صراط? The صراط is a bridge. هو الجسر, it's a bridge that is lengthened over the hellfire. It's a bridge on top of the hellfire. Every person will go over it. Even the muwahid, even the muwahid, the person of tawheed, is going to go over that bridge. نعم. And everybody is going to go over that bridge على قدر أعمالهم. Everyone is going to go over it in accordance to their actions. ويسقط فيه من سقط. And whoever drops will drop into the hellfire. You see, anyone who drops will drop in it. نعم. And anyone who wants to know how he's going to make it on that bridge the day of judgment, let him look at the way he treads on the road of this dunya today. Which road? The road of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at yourself today, where you are when it comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's path, and how you are towards it. That's the same way you're going to be on the path or the bridge of the Sirat, the Day of Judgment. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the ayah, Allah said to him, say to the people, say to them, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. The verses like that, all of them are what? That this path, that the Messenger, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The path of the Messenger that he was upon was what? The path of Tawheed عليه الصلاة والسلام, and the sunnah in which you call to the sunnah as well. You don't call to innovation, you don't call to sinning, and you also stay away from shirk and anything related to it. So wherever you are and however you are on that path is the way you're going to be on the path of the sirat of the Day of Judgment. The people who are going to make it through the sirat, Allah told us are only people who gathered one characteristics. Allah said in the ayah, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كان على ربك حتما مقضيا ثم ننجي الذين اتقوا ونظر الظالمين فيها جثيا. In that verse Allah says, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا. There is not a person except he's going to go on that bridge. He's going to go on the sirat, everybody. And then Allah تبارك وتعالى, he told us, ثم ننجي الذين اتقوا. The people we're going to give safety and prosperity and who are going to make it through are who? الذين اتقوا. The people of taqwa and iman. Who are the people of taqwa? Go back to the definition of Talq ibn Habib. That's the best definition. Jami'un mani'. It's a very comprehensive definition. A definition that gives the whole meaning, the word, its correct meaning. Talq ibn Habib. You will find it in Ibn Rajab Hanbali, his kitab Jami'ul Ulum al-Hakam. Na'am. I think he brings it in the hadith of Irbad ibn Sariya. Or he brings it in the hadith of Abi Dhar. احفظ الله يحفظك. No, he brings it in the hadith of Abu Dhar, which is اتق الله حيثما كنت. Or in the hadith of Irbad ibn Sariya. وعذنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم موعظة. He brings the aqwal there. And the definitions that are regarding the word taqwa. Al-Imam al-Asbahani rahimahullah. There are two ways to say al-Asbahani. Al-Asbahani here is Qawam al-Hujjah, Abu Qasim al-Taymi, the author of the kitab al-Hujjah fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. You can say Asbahani with a ba. And you can also say Asfahani. Ba or fa is the same. Both are said. Al-Imam Abu Qasim al-Taymi, Qawam al-Sunnah, Qawam al-Sunnah, he has a book called al-Hujjah fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. Darul Rayah published it. Darul Rayah. He said, was-siratu haqqun. The sirat is what? It's haqq. يَجُوزُ عَلَيْهِ مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ. He would go over it, the one who Allah wills for it. He will go through it, makes it. وَيَسْقُطُ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ. And he would drop in the hellfire whoever Allah wills for him. وَلَهُمْ أَنْوَارٌ عَلَى قَدْرِ أَعْمَالِهِمْ. And the people have light and they glow that day based on their actions. You see how serious it is. Also Imam Ahmad said the same thing in his in the Risa, there's a narration of Khalal. Abu Bakr al-Khalal, he has a narration where he narrates from who? Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, his Aqidah, and he takes it from him. He said, Imam Ahmad said, وَالصِّرَاطُ حَقٌ وُطِعَ عَلَى سَوَاءِ جَهَنَّمَ. That the sirat is haqq and it's being placed on top of Jahannam. وَيَمُرُّ النَّاسُ عَلَيْهَا. And the people will go over it. وَيَمُرُّ النَّاسُ عَلَيْهِ. وَالْجَنَّةُ مِنْ وَرَاءِ ذَلِكَ. And Jannah is after the sirat. Or after Jannah. It's after all of that. نسأل الله السلامة. Imam Ahmad said, we ask Allah safety. And we also ask Allah تبارك وتعالى that He makes us safe. It is something we ask Allah in our five daily prayers every time. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Oh Allah, guide us on the straight path. Why are we saying, oh Allah, guide us on the straight path? The reason why we do is because we want to be those who do not drop on the sirat of the Day of Judgment. Allah also said in Surah Al-Fath, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَيَهْدِيَكَ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا وَيَنْصُرَكَ اللَّهُ نَصْرًا عَزِيزًا. So وَيَهْدِيَكَ, for Allah to guide you, O Muhammad, صِرَاطًا, a path which is مُسْتَقِيمًا. That is Surah Al-Fath, Ayah 1 to Ayah 3. Ayah 1 to Ayah 3. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that he left us upon clarity. He said, تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى بَيْضَىٰ. I have left you upon whiteness, light. I left you in white. لَيْلُهَا كَنَّهَارِهَا. It's night, it's daytime. لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكَ. No one is destroyed except the one who Allah wants destruction for him. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he died, he had made sure that the people knew the path of this world, how clear and the road that was made for them. You see, that they know it. So when they come to the Day of Judgment and they tread over the sirat, they don't drop. They don't drop. Na'am.
وَالْمِيزَانُ حَقٌ لَهُ كِفَّتَانِ.
The mizan is haqq. The mizan is what? It's a scale in which Allah scales things. Ahlul Sunnah have transmitted that there are things Allah scales. There are what? There are things. From them are actions are scaled, are weighed on it. In the mizan, the Day of Judgment, what is weighed on it is a'mal, people's actions. The person's action is taken and it's weighed. Also, the individual is weighed. Narrations that say, a man would be brought the Day of Judgment, يُؤْتَى بِرَجُّلٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ سَمِينٌ بَدِينٌ. A person who is chubby and big, فَيُوضَعُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ. He is placed on the scale, فَلَا يَزِنُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضَةٍ. And he doesn't weigh in the eye of Allah a wing of a mosquito. So he's weighed. This guy is big. He's chubby. He's placed on the scale. And he doesn't weigh in the eyes of Allah a wing of a mosquito. Also what is weighed is the scrolls in which the actions were written on. And the evidence for that is the hadith of Bitaqa. The hadith of the man who La ilaha illallah saved him. The card that had said it said La ilaha illallah in it. Then the hadith says, he has on the scale 99 sijilla. 99 scrolls are on the scale. And then a card is brought out and it said to him, this card. And then he said, Ya Rabbi, oh my Lord, what will this card do in comparison to the scale? What's already there, the 99 scrolls of sins. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, no one is oppressed today. Everyone will be fairly judged. And so what is taken then? The card is then placed on the scale and it outweighs all his sins. So what's weighed now? The place that the actions were written on. All of those are what? All of those are the weighing that are done on the mizan, the day of judgment. So the Shaykh said, "Wal mizanu, the mizan, haqqun, it is haqq, lahu kiffatani." Kiffa means what? It has two sides. It's got two sides in which the scale it would be weighed. And evidence for that is Surah Al-Qari'ah, ayah 6 to ayah 9. وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا وَكَفَى بِنَا حَاسِبِينَ. Allah also says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. الإمام Al-Qayrawani, rahimahullah, he is in a muqaddimah of his Risala, Aqidah book, which in the introduction he talks about matters of Aqidah. Al-Imam Al-Qayrawani is from the Aimatul Malikiya. He's from the Aimatul Malikiya, whose Aqidah was what? It was Aqidah Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He said, وَتُوضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ لِوَزْنِ أَعْمَالِ الْعِبَادِ. He said that the scale will be placed, and what would be put on it the Day of Judgment? What would be put on it and the actions of the people. The actions of the people will be put on it. And as I said, that's one of the things that are weighed the day of judgment. That is what is weighed the day of judgment. And also the body of the person, I told you the hadith of the man who is going to be brought. Also the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. When the Sahabas, they laughed at him. How he is what? They laughed at him, إِلَى دِقَّةِ سَاقِهِ إِلَى دِقَّةِ سَاقِهِ. How small and little his shin was. When they looked, they laughed at him. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, أَتَعْجَبُونَ مِنْ دِقَّةِ سَاقَيْهِ. Are you guys laughing at how small his shins are? أَمَّا إِنَّهُمَا فِي الْمِيزَانِ لَأَثْقَلُ مِنْ جَبْلِ أُحُدٍ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, for verily, his sacks, which are very little in size, are heavy on the scale of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the Day of Judgment, than the mountain of Uhud. So that shows you that people are going to be weighed the day of judgment. Naam.
والحوض المكرم به نبينا حق.
Also the حوض, the fountain. والحوض المكرم, the honorable حوض, the honorable fountain, which our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is حوض, is for him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, in which Surah Al-Kawthar speaks about. Allah تبارك وتعالى said, إنا أعطينا كالكوثر فصلي لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told us in that verse that he has given Nabiullah Muhammad al-hawd, the kawthar, is his. The Prophet ﷺ also told us himself in the hadith Sahih al-Bukhari, in the hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, that Allah gave him a hawd, and the Prophet described it for us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He told us that the width and the length are both the same. طوله كعرضي. Its length and its width are the same. كُلُّ مِنْهُمَا, each and every one of them is مَسَافَةَ شَهْرٍ, it's a traveling of a month, the Prophet told us. أَبَارِيقُهُ عَدَدُ نُجُومِ السَّمَاءِ, the utensils are like the sky.